promise to go to bed right away? How does every great fairy tale begin?
Once upon a time.
Once upon a time. I wish in a far-off kingdom, more than anything, a deal, more than life, a sad young lad, more than jewels,
rich,
and the baker with his wife.
More than life, I wish. More than anything.
More than love.
Don't strain me,
and save to the sweet. until now has failed.
Who might that be?
We sold our last loaf of bread.
It's the witch from next door.
But we have no bread. Now, of course, you have no bread.
Then what is it that you wish?
It's not what I wish. It's what you wish. Nothing cooking in there now, is there?
The old enchantress went on to tell the couple that she had placed a spell on their house.
What spell?
In the past, when you were no more than a babe, your father had brought his young wife and you to this cottage. They were a handsome couple, but not handsome neighbors. You see, your mother was with child, and she had developed an unusual appetite. She took one look at my beautiful garden and told your father that what she wanted more than anything in the world was greens, greens, and nothing but greens. Parsley, peppers, cabbages, and celery, asparagus, and watercress, and fiddle bells, and lettuce, he said, all right. But it wasn't quite, because I caught him in the autumn in my garden one night. He was robbing me, raping me, running through my rutabaga, raining my arugula, and ripping up the rabbi and my champion, and my favorite. I should have been a stone right there. Could turn him into stone, or a dog, or a chair. But I let him have the rabbi and I've lots to spare. In return, however, I said fair is fair. You can let me have the baby that your wife will bear. Then we'll call it square.
I had a brother?
No. But you had a sister.
But the witch refused to tell him any more of his sister. Not even that her name was Rapunzel. She went on.
I thought I had been more than reasonable, and that we all might live happily ever after. But how was I to know what your father had also hidden in his pocket? You see, when I had inherited that garden, my mother warned me I would be punished if I were ever to lose any of the beans.
Beans?
The special beans.
No.
The little girl with the red cape was in for a surprise.
To my grandmother's.
And what might be in your basket?
Bread and wine, so Granny will have something good to make her strong.
Oh, and where might your grandmother live?
A good quarter of a league further into the woods. Her house stands under three large oak trees.
Thought of that.
Mm-hmm.
I suppose my mother and I will have no food to eat.
This is the sum total.
Bean.